the teams as well as we're getting ever closer to kicking this one off. It is PXL Esports, an undefeated team right now, a part of that university that loves their esports, always out there promoting it, hoping that you can see the Rocket League get a little bit more of that love, taking on UGent, Yellow into this one, home of Sybe, who, I mean, as we were kind of talking about before, Greybeard, Sybe, a well-known face in the community.
Off stream, he was saying, I was like, Sybe, oh, he's awesome. He's offering my chat. And everybody else is like, yeah, he's in everybody's chat. So one of those people who clearly loves the game, wants to support in any way he is. So that's pretty cool to see him there and being part of it.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully, though, he will be able to come out there and bring that team some of that success. You can see the rosters right now down below as we get ever closer to this game. This time, we'll go back in that reverse order. So, Greybeard, right back to you. Who's winning this series?
Well, what's amazing about these two teams, Pixel, PXL, UGent, they are both undefeated, but they are separated in stats by goal difference, a single goal. I mean, that's how close these two teams are. So if there was ever a series set up for a game five, it is with these two. But it's not just numbers. And oh, so just so you know, the technical underdog then is UGent because they've got the lower goal difference by one. But I'm going to go with UGent. I think they'll take it.
Yeah, I knew you were going to go somewhere because you don't use the stats. You always have to break away from it. Of course. I don't know. Psycho, talk some sense into us.
It's very difficult to do that, to be honest, but I think there is... I did have a brief sneaky look at the actual games that have been played by both of these teams so far in the league, and I think the one which has had a better, inverted commas, sort of result, maybe UGent, because they actually beat Hovest, who I've watched on stream when I did a cast with Dennis before as well. They looked very strong, so that's going to be the only thing which possibly sways it for me.
All right. Well, you know what? I'm here to be convinced, okay? Greybeard and Psycho, and I think you've done just that. Listen, I think I was able to see the main roster of UGent, and I was very impressed. So I'm ready for that to bleed into their yellow squad as well. They're going to pose that undefeated record and hold on to it.
All right. Before I make my prediction, just real quick, Psycho, have you gotten a prediction correct yet today?
That's a good question. So the Vans lost... Yeah, probably. I'm just gonna say probably. Yeah, I've lost them all.
I don't think you have. Yeah. I don't think you have. Give me PXL. Oh. Give me Pixel. I don't think Psycho's got one right. I gotta go the other way on this one. I gotta keep my 100% still safe.
Are you 100%? You're at 100%.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening either. I'm scared too. Okay.
Well, listen, I'm at 100%. So yeah, we're the same that way.
Hold on. Did you not pick the Erasmus Eagles that last series?
Oh.
Yeah, no. I've picked every losing team. Yeah, 100%.
Oh, okay. Well, that's fine. You know what? You got to put 100% club. Greybeard, you're with me. We're going to go ahead and cast this next series then, and we'll let Pyro and Psycho figure out where their picks went so wrong. This is going to be a fun one. UGent, going to go up against PXL, and I wish I knew more about these teams. I wish I could tell you in more detail about these players, their styles, but it's going to be a learning experience, I feel like, for us each.
Yeah, and that's the joy. We're certainly, by the end of this, going to have a better idea, and I don't know how often or indeed if these two have met up or what their results have been. So, you know, they are both undefeated and have not conceded, not only one of them has conceded a single goal. So I don't know, will the play styles complement each other? Will it sort of stalemate that way? Or will one dominate the other? But certainly the many questions we have now, Formal, at least some of, we'll have more answers by the end of the series.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm excited to kick this one off and see how these two sides sort of fare. Two evenly matched sides tells me we could be getting something special. Do we get our third five-game series of the evening? We can only hope, especially what it means staying undefeated at the end of the day. Now, I do believe we're getting ready to kick this one off any given moment. The word has been given to go, go, go. The players are jumping on to the pitch. Game number one, Greybeard. Let's kick this off.
Let's go, Commandos. It's howling time. Of course, there is always the one possibility, Formal, when you have two teams that have the record that these two have, that it isn't as close as we expect and one just dominates the other. But
Oh, yeah. Oh,
we'll have more answers soon enough. They are away. And there's going to be a very, very quick goal. Almost a pickoff. 6 seconds in, the ball just banged into the midfield. And Xander picking up the loose and placing it perfectly.
I liked the confidence from you, Ghent. I liked the trust and the faith. All three members pressing forward, expecting Scribbly to make the touch. And instead, it goes the other way. So a little bit of a spooky start, I have to say, from the U-Ghent side. But it's only early days. They can still bring it back. And let's see what we do when the game settles a little bit.
All right. Well, now they're doing better. They've managed to get it right in front of the net. Saib can't find the final killer touch. And now it's the other side. Mauro has a shot. It's wide. But they look more threatening, the Pixel side, right now when they're going forward, rather than what we're seeing from U-Ghent at the moment. But we're inside the first minute. It is a single goal, not like that earlier series where we had five inside the first minute.
Oh, don't speak too soon. The demos are coming out and space is being given to U-Ghent as they're going to be looking to make the play. Saib has a peek over the middle, but not quite as fast as Xander, who will get the second touch, beat Scribbly, but couldn't keep it straight. Enough done defensively for the first save. A chance for the second. Will have to come from above. Xander just throws it right back to the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's being brought right back there. Stuck over on the U-Ghent side for the time being. Pressure building here for Pixel, trying to improve on their one goal lead. F-Blade has it. And after a little bit of time in the corner, comes out, but they're doing very well here. This threatening pressure that slowly sucks the oxygen out of the defense. So far, U-Ghent doing okay, but it starts to get very wobbly.
Yeah, I mean, the thing that was scaring me right there was the fact that no one from the U-Ghent side was, like, really willing to press up too far until it's actually Pixel that backs away to collect their own back corner boosts that allows the U-Ghent side to actually feel confident enough to challenge in the middle of the field. I'm hoping that's not going to be a reoccurring thing. I'm hoping we get to see U-Ghent again show that confidence, but with a little bit more competency, like we saw out of the kickoff. Although on defense, they're going to be in danger here. Double commit. The first touch was made, but no boost gathered just yet. It is Saib who picks it up, and it is Scribbly who crosses the field.
The pressure there, they're giving so much space. There was the double commit. Finally, that's going to go in. Xander gets a second. And yeah, you know, you just it had that it's just a matter of time feeling about it, right? The pressure just goes on. And eventually, the patience wears thin. The defense wears thin. And it's two goals up for Pixel.
Yeah, it's really strange to me because it feels like the U-Ghent side, they're good at making the first defensive touch, but they're not putting it in a threatening spot, and they're not even attempting to follow it up. Like, it feels as if they're doing the bare minimum to try to keep the ball out of the net, and that's not going to cut it. I don't want to see defenders waiting in line for their turn to make the save. I want to see a little bit more proactivity coming from this U-Ghent team. Hopefully we get that as this game progresses. I mean, still early days, and we still haven't really seen what they look like on the attacking side. Maybe we'll get a little bit of flair of brilliance here.
Yeah, they've had brief moments. They'll have one here. Zirek Zareksik will get goal number one for U-Ghent. They find themselves on the board. Oh, the back pass and the massive bump opening up the net.
Mauro also had with a swing and a miss. A lot of things had to come together for that goal, Greybeard. The big one, though, was Saib with the bump. That was fantastic. Now another chance off the kickoff. Zyrek was there. Doesn't make contact. Saib is there. Will push it towards the net. And again, it's touch ball back off. Touch ball back off. So rarely are we seeing this U-Ghent side follow up their touches.
All right. Maybe now Saib was trying to pick it out of the midfield. Does he get the double? Xander is there to see it away. But there does seem to at least be a more positive opportunities.
No.
And running away in. Oh, he misses it in the last second. He pushes it wide.
But he pulled off again. And they stuck with the play. The goal was there. You just had to hit the brakes a little bit. And it would have bounced off the front corner and gone in. It always feels like the moment something doesn't go right for U-Ghent, their initial reaction is the pullback on defense. I can't help but feel like they left one sitting on the table. However, that was a great mechanical setup. It's only a matter of time. Scribbly puts it through and we're tied.
Yeah, and finally, You know, early on, we saw the pressure from Pixel, building that pressure where they eventually break down the defense. There was a little bit in this, and they haven't looked fantastic, Jürgen, but they fought their way back in. And I think now we're going to have a little bit of a different game now they've managed to claw it back, and perhaps they can overcome the observation you've made of being a little bit more proactive going forward.
Well, that was some proactivity coming from the Pixel side. Demo comes through, but the save this time is there. Three defenders rotating back once again. Xander tries to punish, although Zurexic is there for the touch. Now Scribbly versus F-Blade is able to find that touch, but no one wants to challenge Xander through that corridor. And is this super passive playstyle? Look, if it's going to work for them, I'll stop criticizing it. They have tied the game. They have a chance to flip the map right now. Here comes the proactivity. Sibe is already down. Pass back to Zurexic, who can't quite find the straight shot.
Man, that was the whole buildup. Everything was perfect until it wasn't. Not finding the net. But much better from Jürgen. And I do think they're settling in. And maybe, hopefully, we'll break out the passive. Xander, though, looking for a third. Cut out by Scribbly. F-Blade, if he can get an angle and a pass quick enough, the net was open for a brief moment. But we're rapidly heading for a game one overtime. Or are we?
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, my God. That was not it. And look, I have to say right now, thank goodness these two teams are going toe-to-toe right now on the pitch right now, because what I'm seeing in the Twitch chat between the two quote-unquote orgs, that's the lamest excuse for a showdown I've ever seen. Overtime happening, though. Two goals aside, let's see who takes this game number one.
Well, this is what we would have expected with two teams as close as these two are in stats and record in this particular league so far. So panning out from the paper, at least in game one. 30 seconds, late. Overtime, gone away. Maru, it's high off the, oh, it's loose. It's a scramble here for Jürgen, looking a little bit pushed back. They survive for now, but the pressure continues.
It's fine when you only push about like 5 meters forward every time, then it's easy to rotate back and have another go at the save, as this defense has been so inclined to show us. And I'm starting to become a believer. Is it how I would, you know, coach a team to play defense? Not at all, but it's working for them. And you can see how frustrating it is for Pixel to get that goal in time and time again. But I do have to say this, when Jürgen gets on the attacking side, they do look a lot more dangerous. That's where their mechanics start to fly in. That's where they save their own shots.
The own save, oh dearie me. Might not have gone in anyway, but not doing themselves any favors. And so it continues, stalemate for now. And you mentioned it's working for them. So perhaps the two play styles canceling each other out a little bit, putting us into the stalemate situation where neither breaks through. We have these brief forays forward from Jürgen, and then the long forays forward by Pixel, but neither breaking through.
Sibe had a chance right there, wound up missing it, and no way that goes in. And Xander steals it, because why not? There we go. Overtime goes in favor of Pixel.
There we go. Xander does get the hat trick in cheeky fashion, but hat trick. Absolutely. All right. So on a balance of play, I think the result is a fair one. Pixel come out front. They took the two relatively early goals, the comeback from Jürgen, but overtime goes to Pixel.
Yeah, it's strange game. Strange game right now. A lot of unforced errors. More so on the Jürgen side, but at the same token, Jürgen, to me, they're the better. I want to say they were the more impressive team in that first game. When it came down to the mechanics, when it came down to what they were able to do with space, they looked to be the stronger team, and that's kind of why I'm like pulling my hair out watching their playstyle, because their playstyle doesn't reflect what this team's strengths appear to be right now. I want to see them be a bit more proactive. I want to see them follow through a bit more on these touches, and they could be right in it right now, because I think they're the faster team. I think they're the more mechanical team, but they're also the team less willing to take risks.
All right, well, they have to answer up. They've got to find a way through, so perhaps they will change it up a little. Bring that play a bit more aggressively forward as we head into game two. And I mean, I'm fully expecting them to change something up here, take this game to level the series as we wind our way to perhaps an inevitable game five. But we have to get through game two first, which gets underway now.
Yeah, I feel as if we don't see that play style change, we won't be seeing the game five, but I trust the Yugen side. It's something I've noticed a lot every time we do kind of get to cover EU Rocket League, Greybeard. It does feel like the European style, they really like to slow play game one and then accelerate more and more as the series go, which from what I've seen from your region and definitely what I've seen from my own, not really how the smaller regions play the game.
Yes. And I think that does bear out from what we saw tonight. Certainly that first series with Pesto, who kind of took their sweet time and then almost took it. This is going to be a goal. Maru gets it in. And it is opening goal from Pixel, as they did in game one.
Yeah, that was just, well, that's kind of what I'm talking about. Following through with the touches, being willing to be that next aggressor. And we saw it right there from the Pixel side. Super fast to the play, Maru. Able to get there and make it a 1-0 lead.
All right, so more pressing for Yugen to do. A game behind, a goal behind. Zarexek trying to get something going, smashes it off the ceiling, and now might be in a bit of strife as they have to defend a forward play here, which they do for now. So holding off, but are a goal behind.
For the time being, Xander is just kind of running the defense wild. Saib eventually will break it out. F-Blade falling back makes the first touch. An unnecessary second touch as well. Kind of keeps it away from their own teammates. But eventually the ball continues to stay jammed in the corner. All right. Well, that was an awkward play. And I'm seeing a lot of touches, seeing not a lot of follow through. And eventually the BAP did get flipped.
Dribbly trying to find the ball to get a pass in front. Doesn't get it. And it's going to go loose back into the Yugen corner. Or Saib is expertly undone, dispossessed. And immediately, some more pressure from Pixel.
All right, here we go. How do they play defense this time? Saib pushes it forward. And then it's a double commit in the corner, but Saib stayed forward. And there we go. That's that little bit of adaptation I wanted to see. Turns it into a pass, turns it into pressure. And then an unforced error by F-Plate means the pressure gets extended. Things now starting to come together for the Yugen side.
Yeah, we can see they're all on pretty short rotations right now. Not backing off all the way. Scribbly might put them under a little bit of strife with that whiff there. They were doing so well. Short rotations, keeping the pressure up. But then they release it through a whiff. But they do have... Oh, Scribbly gives it away. That was a potentially building play.
I mean, they still can, though. Zarex, because there was the tighter spacing, was able to quickly get to the play. And now it's a pass across the middle. Here comes Syme. Shot straight down the center to Scribbly. What a pass, shot, and goal. And this is the Yugen side I was hoping to see.
That was fantastic. What a touchdown, but what a follow. There you go, having a teammate with him, understanding where the play was going, being in the right place, level game. So we know now, Formal, that Yugen can level a lead, but can they take one? That's their next challenge, is to go in front.
Eyes are going to be on them for sure to do it. I mean, I don't know if the two schools realize it yet, but that check mark next to Pixel Esports, they lose it if Yugen is able to win this series out. Yeah, I don't know how to tell you guys this, but verification on the line in this series, not to mention defending that undefeated record. So we'll see if they're going to be able to maintain it. Now knowing that they're playing for it, though, all of a sudden, Xander elevates their play and makes it a 2-1 lead.
Xander with his fourth goal in the series. Zarexek under had a very bad recovery, couldn't get back, and they are punished. Back in front, but by only one, and enough time for things to change.
Yeah, that check mark's looking a little safer for now. One goal lead, one game lead for Pixel in this one, as Scribbly's going to pop it up, and also... To go back to, you know, the series you cast earlier, how most European Rocket League series go, the tempo of this game has increased from game number one. It's something about EU Rocket League. They like to start it slow, just keep going faster and faster and faster. And Belgium, no exception to that rule.
A running start to a series. And, Scribbly, not for the first time, making a bit of a whiff in the midfield, but this time they don't get into too much trouble. There's been a defensive demo, but the ball does come loose. Who gets here first? It's going to go into the corner. Something building here, but now pressure released, and suddenly defending having to be done, and it is done through a long forward clear.
Yeah, that Zarexic was actually the first one to get to as well, so got the clear and caught their own pass. not sure what Pixel Esports' defense was doing in that situation. And it's the exact same angle. Scribbly able to stay it as well. So these cross-pitch clears going corner to corner. Definitely seems to get Pixel a little bit confused how to read it. Either way, under a minute to go. And this is dangerous. Saib, oh, can't quite put it straight for a dangerous shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you're shooting or looking for Scribbly, who was trying to get on the end of a pass. Either way, neither works out. And 40 seconds to go, and they are behind once more. They've spent most of the series so far chasing the game. Never had a lead on their own. F-Blade with a
long shot.
Nah, Scribbly gets up. This time not missing the ball. Gets the touch, gets it away. But it is still 20 seconds to go, and Jugend are going to go two behind here unless they can make some magic happen. It's on the right side of the pitch for them. It's falling awkward. Oh, my goodness gracious. They don't quite make it happen there.
10 seconds left. They might get one more chance, but first they got to flip the map one more time. Zorexic just slowing Xander down, but a slower pace is only going to make things more difficult. Timer hits zero. Ball gets cleared straight to F-Blade, who really could have let that one drop. Instead, we keep going back and forth as Xander just says, enough of this silliness. We're going to game three, 2-0 lead in favor of Pixel.
And now the inevitable game five, maybe not as inevitable as we might have assumed, as close as it has been. Again, I think a fair result formal with Pixel taking both by one goal, but I think they did have the better of it. Jugend chasing the game well, but just can't pull themselves ahead.
It's consistency that's keeping Pixel ahead right now. Like, Jugend makes more exciting plays. I still think they're the faster team. I still think they can be that more mechanical team, but they're also making more errors, be that positional errors with double commits, be that sometimes missing the ball. Pixel, they're playing a very conservative game, and not conservative in the sense where they're staying back all the time, but it's just, you know, bare bones, Rocket League, standard rotations, player hits, player hits, player hits, and as soon as the mistake gets made, be in position to punish. And we saw how quickly they punish when that mistake comes through. Maru's first goal, a classic example of that. So as we go into game number three, we need to see the consistency. If we don't see the consistency from Jugend, they're going to wind up losing out. So hopefully they can put together a clean 5 minutes.
Well, it's do or die time. win or go home, and they're going to win three on the trot. So you talk about consistency. They're going to have to be as consistent as it is possible to be in order to take three in a row. Oh, my goodness. That just had goal written on it, right? It just felt like it was going to go there. It doesn't go in, and they don't get the opener. They've scored the opener in every game. And Skibbley, again, he's having a rough series formal. Missing the ball in important places, and he pulls off an important save there. But it could be argued he had to make it, given his earlier whiff on the wall.
Yeah, that was a big-time save coming from Skibbley, who's now going to be pushing it forward. But so far, these first 30 seconds kind of proving exactly what I'm talking about when it comes to this Pixel side. If they can sniff that opening, that's when they take their shot. But outside of that, it's just, you know, pretty basic rotational Rocket League. The thing is, we've just had two openings early, and that's an opening the other way. Skibbley, surrounded by teammates, makes it a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, and I think that starts to change things. Wow, what a touch from Saib on the wall. Undid the entire Pixel team to pretty much open the net completely, and every player from Jugend there to make sure that one goes in. And for the first time, they do have a lead. And maybe now, formal, they claw their way back into the series. Oh, a dim up front! And suddenly the plays happen. Two goals in about 10 seconds. And what a quick turnaround.
How great do you look when you follow through after your touch and try to create a little bit more pressure? Saib doing it right there. Got the setup, got the demo, and just got to sit back and watch as the team puts it through. Great individual play, great team follow-up, and now a 2-0 lead. That's going to be a 2-1 lead. It's the Zyrexic is able to go back and make the save.
That's amazing. I mean, that was a golden opportunity for Pixel to get back here. F-Blade now making the miss. Xander making the miss. And Zyrexic can't. Oh, it's still there and awkward. So mistakes from both sides there in defense and then in attack. But it is Pixel still under pressure, and somehow they concede one there.
3-0, and now we're seeing the strengths of what this Jugend type can do, and it's all with Sieb being proactive. The proactivity I've been kicking and screaming for coming through not once but twice, as it is a big turnaround in terms of both style and performance out of this Yujin side.
Yeah, and the entire complexion of the series changes now. It was all Pixel, and now we have Yuchent clawed back in, and unless something goes catastrophically wrong here, a massive throw, they should be taking that. Having said that, there's still a massive 3 minutes left, so plenty time for Pixel to sort themselves out. But I think to your earlier point, you know, they're playing solid Rocket League and punishing the mistakes. And if you can start making fewer mistakes and become a bit more consistent going forward, perhaps that play style, it will no longer be enough.
I think that's what we're going to see. But again, I just love the way how Saib has been playing this game in particular. Really been helping turn it around. And now we'll get another chance right here. Now that's not as good of a look. And that makes it even worse, Saib. No, don't pass it back when you have no defenders there. Oh. That's going to be a goal going the other way. And it's now 1-3.
Yeah, and you... So, oh my goodness. Zorexic yeeted to Narnia there. And we talk about changing complexion, and it's like, okay, the complexion of the series changes, but now the complexion of the game does, because it's half the game and now only a two-goal game. It seems scarily closer now.
The most dangerous lead in football, that two-goal lead, and Xander's threatening. Couldn't quite make contact, though. A chance to put themselves up by three once again. Goes high, follow-up for Skidley. If they keep it high, in, and now it's a 4-1 lead.
All right, okay, so that's going to resettle things. And, Skidley doing very well with the follow there. Find the ball, get it in, 4-1, three-goal lead. And now maybe a little bit more comfort with that cushion.
Yeah, you would hope so. You would hope so. Seen crazier things in the past, and with how kind of gung-ho all of a sudden Yugen's getting, be a little bit cautious as well. The double commit head has been kind of sneaking through every now and then. Skibbley, though, will slow it down. You have Saib right behind waiting. We'll have to make a more defensive play instead. Actually wound up missing F-Blade, though. Runs out of boost, leaves it for Moru before committing once again, and that's a big whiff.
Oh, dear.
Oh.
Yeah. You know what? That massive whiff is one thing when you got your third man right behind you. When you have nothing but a clear run to the net, that's a rough one, and they are punished. As Pixel have done, they are now punished for the mistake.
Yeah, that third man was stealing, you know, boost on the opposite corner on the attacking half. Like, that was a very unfortunate miss right there. But, you know, there's still two more games. And for Pixel, it's a lot easier to reset that medal and get yourselves moving forward. This was a good turnaround for you, Gent. They're still going to have to do it two more times. Still going to have to hold on for just over a minute as well in this one. I see no reason why they can't, however.
All right, well, there's time here. I would imagine if that goes in, then it's pretty much done and dusted there. But Pixel, for the remainder of this, will want to salvage something from it, close that gap, not make it such a dominating win by Yuchent if they possibly can, and then reset themselves. They still have the series advantage. They just have to win one more game. Yuchent have to win the next two. So nothing to be overly concerned about, but there is always concern when you've been doing as well as you have and then suddenly you give one up in this fashion.
Yeah, I don't know, though. Like, I like to think of myself as somewhat of a realist when it comes to the possibility of reverse sweeps. And this one is far more likely than normal because, like, I've been saying it since the start of this series. I feel like the Yugen side has the potential to be the better team. Even in the games that they lost, there were signs of them where I'm like, okay, no, this team can't be competitive. This was the first game where we finally saw it all come together. So, yeah, it's still very doable that they can win those next two. For me, the earnest comes back on Pixel. The passive style, waiting for the opponent's mistakes, is finally run into some speed bumps right now. They're going to have to be a little bit more proactive, a little bit more aggressive in their own rights. Take a couple more risks moving forward, because now they're going to have to earn this series win.
Well, Yuchent have had their running start. They started slow, passive, touch and go, see how it happens. They've fully warmed up now, and I think your point is well made. It's Pixel's opportunity, Pixel's necessity now to change things up and meet Yuchent at their now that they're warmed up and into the swing of things.
And for both better and worse, I feel like the player to look out for right now is going to be Fblade. Not just because they scored that goal in that game, but I've noticed a lot of the more aggressive challenges, as few as they've been from Pixel, has been courtesy of Fblade. Fblade has been the player most likely to play forward, most likely to be a little bit ball chasey. And I think this series is going to kind of fall on him. If Fblade's able to make plays, things will be good for Pixel. But if Fblade gets exposed, like we kind of saw with a couple of, you know, their own whiffs, like we saw in that last game, things could continue to go poorly. So keep eyes on Fblade in this game. Pixel success kind of depends on Fblade having a good one.
All right. Well, here we are. Game four. It is Pixel. Still with the series advantage, with the extra game that they are ahead. But a resurgent Jugend looking, having clawed their way back in, staved one, fought of 1 point of elimination. They're going to have to do it again.
Yeah, let's see if they can bring it all back together one more time. I want to go back to Champions Field. It's a nice place, you know. The food that they sell there, a little pricey, but it's top quality, you know. 4.5 stars, I'd say. It's worth a repeat visit.
Beer in high-quality plastic cups. So there we are. Although, you know what, the only result we haven't seen tonight is a 3-1. We've had the sweeps and we've had Champions Field. So it'll be nice to get all the possible results.
Yeah, you can have that with the next series. Ooh. Although Xander says we want it now. 1-0, and there's one unforced error, and there's the next miss, and here comes miss number 3.
And Skibbly left all alone. It's the worst position to be in. You're in the middle of the net with a player on the ball who's about to bang it in. You're like, well, I'm going to jump and hope for the best here. And it is Pixel scoring first. And when they have scored first, historically, in this series, they've not lost.
I want the percentage of that, because you're right for this series. But I'm talking about, like, overall, what is the, like, goal, the first goal win percentage following? Just, like, in Rocket League overall. I'd genuinely be curious, because it feels like it should be around 70, 75% of the time.
That, and I guarantee you. Oh, well, there we go. We've leveled up through the work of Sive. So early. But we did see them do this. Game one, game two, they were able to overcome a deficit, but then struggled to get ahead. But they've done the first job. They've leveled it up. And guaranteed, there is someone somewhere formal who has that stat.
Yeah, I'm gonna try and find them. I'm gonna talk to some of the Liquipedia experts out there, the masters. Actually, you know what? I'm going to talk to some of the Uni Rocketeer statisticians, because they put in great work, might I add. I'm just gonna throw them all a shout. The entire stat team doing phenomenal work here at Uni Rocketeers. As we continue moving along, though, right now we are going to see a bit of a chance, a late flip. It was dangerous, but Moaru was able to make the save.
All right, and it is still Jugend possession, although Maru does very well. Fblade, the player you were talking about, gets a nice 50. Moving the play forward, I'm not sure who's going to land up with possession. Another 50 through Sive falls nicely for Jugend, and it is now almost in a position of awkward attack, but that was very nicely taken out, very calmly taken out by Pixel.
Calmly for the time being. Still pressure, though, coming from the Pixel side. Fblade gets two attackers to commit, and that opens the door for Maru. Good touch, good assist, greatest goal. 2-1 in favor of PXL.
Oh man, Sive, coming off the wall. He had that first touch, but he just served to make it more awkward and couldn't do anything. He was out of the play, leaving another player stranded and on his own. Pixel, again, game advantage, goal advantage. They are in prime position to take this series 3-1. It is Jugend struggling to have the dominance they had in the last game, where their playstyle was finally paying off. Pixel, though, holding firm here in game four with a single slim one-goal lead.
Moru almost got the bump through the squishy right there to open the doorway. That would have been sick. Two-goal lead would feel pretty fine right now for Pixel. As it stands, they're going to have to play a little bit of defense, or they should have. Oh no, I'm getting a little worried. We're seeing returning trends. We're seeing players rotating back with no one committing for a ball up for grabs.
Oh, Skibbly had an opportunity. I'm not sure. I don't know if he ran out of boost, but he just couldn't reach the ball for an angle on net. And now they've got defending to do. F-Blade through the corner, down into the midfield. Maru doesn't commit too far forward, and maybe correctly so, at least for now. Loose in the middle, and F-Blade gets it away.
That was awkward defense, but now it's turning into an attack. The counter is good. Xander, two-goal cushion. Pixel, just a minute and a half away.
And they've struggled in this position, and it's a massive red flag for them now, because when they've gone behind like this, they have really battled. We saw last game, they took a lead. Once they had a lead, they were all over it. They were in command of that game. But when they're in positions coming from behind, it's been a struggle for them. And if this goes in, and it does, an initial save, and then F-Blade there for the rebound. Oh, and that might be enough for Pixel.
F-Blade, disgusting play right there. Patient on the attack, puts it through. Player who was kind of called off, or I have to admit, has actually been the most silent member of the team. So big shout out to both Maru and Xander for stepping up in this game four. However, even F-Blade is going to get themselves involved. And with a three goal cushion, Greybeard, I'm feeling pretty confident in Pixel's chances.
Yeah, I mean, again, we're in the territory now where they would really have to throw at this point to give up three goals with a minute to go. And in all likelihood, we are going to have the one result we haven't had tonight, which is a 3-1 series win. And these two undefeated teams, probably Jugend will end the night the undefeated, or the defeated team.
Yeah, as we're continuing our final 50 seconds remaining in this one, Maru is going to push one up deep. Xander tries to drop it back down, but Seeb is there. Already getting pressured a little bit as well. 38 seconds. This attack has to bear fruit. It has to be a goal, and Ghibli just missed it entirely. That is going to do it, I dare say. Yeah. Start your victory lap if you're Pixel. You're winning this series 3-1.
Yeah, you felt if they got a goal at 30 seconds, it's not out of the realms of possibility, of reality, for there to be two bizarre kind of kickoff goals. But now, opportunity has just crossed over the horizon, around the curve, and fallen out of sight. 23 seconds to go. Pixel, they've shown up here. They have been the better team for the most part of this entire series. And by virtue of, as you have pointed out, just playing solid Rocket League, just doing the basics better for longer.
Yeah, I'm going to say this, and it's going to sound like an insult, but it really isn't. And so, but the most exciting thing about this Pixel team is where they're from. It's this Pixel esports group, because again, a lot of different esports covered by Pixel. Obviously, you know, they strive to be the best across Belgium in all of these different facets and avenues, and they've gotten that reputation for themselves. That's the exciting part. The team, they play a pretty low-key style, but they play it really, 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 really well. And you don't have to be flash exciting to win games. You don't have to get those big highlight plays. You just have to be more consistent than your opponent, and that's going to win you matches 90% of the time. That's exactly what Pixel did right here. So, like I said at the start of this stream here, Greybeard, I hope Pixel starts to give this Rocket League team more and more love, because they're absolutely deserving of it right now.
And wasn't there a similar criticism leveled or statement made about BDS? Like, they're not the most exciting Rocket League, but they won everything. They just did the basic stuff well and plowed their way through teams. And so far, working for them, they remain